same. This is the demo of the inventory simplification story. So with respect to the 8.5.0 beta, we have the CAN report server beta channel, which needs to be subscribed. So this is the channel. The SRS 5.0 beta is the channel. Once you double click on install it, you get the setup propagation install up front. And this by default installs the channel required to act as the scan report server to the C:install directory. You'll get a directory named install. So meanwhile, after the SRS is installed, you need to set the Java underscore home for the computer. So the Java underscore home environment variable is set to the location of the GRE. This is required, this Java underscore home directory is required for the SRS scan report server to start effectively. So once it is set, click on OK. And now go to the install directory of the scan report server and double click on the startup. So it takes a while for the scan report server to start. The scan report server can be installed on any machine irrespective of the master transmitter machine or the insertion machine. So currently I have hosted the SRS on the same machine where the master transmitter is present. So once after the waiting period, the scan report server initializes and it initializes with the data directory and MRBS scan report repository. So this is the default directory where the scan report server gets initialized. So C:. So by default the directory is empty as it has not archived any files. So this section completes the scan report server configuration of the Java underscore home and the startup of it by double clicking the scan report server. So this is the file that we used for startup. And this is the window, that is the console associated with the scan report server and its login directory. So now, after the SRS is configured, let's move on to configuring the inventory plugin with the scan report server URL. So I'm routing the transmitter through the TMS hosted on this machine. So this is the machine. And I'm configuring it. So this transmitter which hosts the 8.5 W beta inventory service. We just need to provide the scan report server URL. By default, it is initialized to the local host where we have started our scan report server. So just we need to ensure that it is, the plugin is enabled and appropriate endpoint details, endpoint configurations are provided, and we just need to publish it. So once we publish it, what happens behind the transmitter machine, that is the insertion machine, we get three new pop-ups and these modules are associated with the standalone inserter. So these are the three consoles which act the standalone separately outside of the transmitter, thereby serving the insertion. So these components work in integration with the CAN report server, which is hosted on this machine. So the final state after the startup looks up like this. So these are the three components which together form the standalone insertor. And we also need to ensure that the CAN report server is started. We have the CAN report server already started. So the standalone insertor components, namely the OpenGMS, standalone report listener, and the report file listener, all the three work in conjunction and integration with the CAN report server. So now coming to the CAN inspection. So once it is initialized, let's go and browse the inventory plugin log. So this is the inventory plugin log that has been configured. So this is the state of the plugin. We just published it with enabled, and the database connection has been activated, and it is connected to the database, which is hosted on the same machine. So now, once the connection is established, let's scan the machine. So once the scanner runs to completion, the scan report is sent to the inventory plugin, and from the inventory plugin the report is moved in the JMS format to the standalone inserter. So these are the various folders as a part of the standalone inserter. So the message which moves over to the inventory plugin queue gets moved over to the inserter. So let's wait for the scan to get completed. So this movement of data from the plugin queue folder to the standalone inserter, the message is very quick in nature, so we cannot find the movement, but we can verify the same from the request being sent to the SRS. So the SRS specifically gets hold of the report, and it gets archived in its queue and then sends the report to the database. So we can go on checking the channel plugin history log. So the report got inserted. The first report from the machine is a full report. The next consecutive report sent from the endpoint is though a full report. The SRS primarily has archived the initial full report. So the next consecutive report, though it is sent as a full report from the endpoint, it is compiled against the archived full report. I will show you the archived full report. So under the SRS repository location, MRD scan repository, scan report repository, we find their archived report for which the scanner was just run. We ran the scanner just 2 minutes back, and by the timestamp we have the full report archived over here by the SRS. So this log indicates the SRS has archived the received report. So now let's perform another scan. As already mentioned, this scan sends a full report, but the SRS dips it against the existing full report, and the generated the dip report is inserted into the database. Let's verify the same. So the Kanban service has just stopped. So let's open the inventor plugin view. It's still not. So the inserted report is a diff report. Let's confirm the report sent from the scanner side is in fact a full report. So once we open the scanner history directory, history logs, we find that the report sent from the endpoint is in fact a full report. Though full report is sent, the plugin, that is the standalone inserter, talks to the scan report server and fetches this full report which is already archived and generates a diff, and then the diff report is inserted. So this is the whole motive behind the inventory simplification story, that though the endpoints send the full report, the standalone inserter which already holds the archived full report is primarily important in creating and generating the diff, and standalone inserter inserts the generated diff report into the database. So by this, the checksum sync operation is totally eliminated by the new inventory simplification design. So let me show you the report of the scanned machine. From the report center, query builder, you can view the results of the scanned machine. So this is the machine that was just scanned. So this is the machine. So once you on the hardware data, the software data, which was scanned, and the usage data which was scanned, are all reported. So the scanner, you can also look at the scanner which was used for scanning from the available channel. So, and it shows the scanner service 8.50 beta as running. So with this, we are completing the inventory simplification 8.50 beta. Thanks.